Hello, in this video I'm going to talk to you about the fastest way to germinate seeds. In particular, I am using vegetable seeds or zucchini seeds. I found these seed raising pellets in a supermarket, Aldi they were, and I thought that looks really practical, mess-free, easy way to transfer seedlings and get them into the garden. But I wanted to know, do they work? Do seed raising pellets work? And how do they compare to other methods of germinating seeds? In particular, there's the traditional method of just popping them in some soil, and there's also the paper towel method as well. And I thought, well, the best way to find out is to do an experiment. So I planted a whole lot of seeds at the same time, zucchini seeds for the purpose of this experiment, some in the seed raising pellets or the pods as I call them, some straight into soil, premium potting mix, and some in paper towel. And it was really, really interesting what happened. Stay tuned to find out.
So the first thing you have to do with the seed raising pellets is to soak them in water. It took longer than I expected for them to rise, probably about 15 minutes before they were big enough and full of water enough to expand and ready for the seeds to go in.
It's so easy, a two-year-old can do it. Is it done? Is it done? Show me. Is indeed. Seeds in there. Well done, treasure. On to the next one.
That one.
Are we going to put a seed in there?
Yeah.
Can you? Oh, good girl. You did it.
And over here, I'm going to use the traditional method of planting some zucchini seeds straight into some premium potting mix. Like this. Covering them up and giving them a really good water.
Let's see which ones are quicker. Our pellets or the original method, straight into some soil.
Or alternatively, into paper towel, which I will soak and then fold over and put into a sealed plastic bag so that it stays moist.
And at day five, we still have no movement from the seeds that were planted in soil and no movement from the seeds that were planted into the pods. At least not that I can see. Let us see what's in here. Oh, that's cool. That is very cool. That is after about 5 days. Okay, the verdict is in. It has been exactly 9 days since these seeds were planted. And we're gonna find out which have grown the quickest. So let's have a look at my paper towel, which has been damp and enclosed in a clear plastic bag. Okay, ooh, they're starting to stick together a bit. I'm gonna have to be really delicate separating them, and it's definitely time for them to go into some soil. But you can see they've grown some pretty decent roots, and if they were in the soil, they would be about to pop out. These ones are just starting to sprout, but they certainly haven't popped through as much as the others. But you can see this guy is just starting to come through here. But comparing to the seeds that were planted straight into the soil, these are definitely the front runners. Definitely the front runners. So, zucchini seeds in soil sprout for me.
quicker than in seed pods or in paper towel. But both other methods have been pretty close behind. So there's actually not a huge difference yet. I will be very interested to see if the pods are more practical as they get bigger. Let's wait and find out.
So because these sprouts aren't going to last much longer in the paper towel, I am just going to plant them into some soil and then see how they continue to grow.
I want to grow sunflowers now.
Look at the difference now. These guys are really big and getting quite leggy because you can see that they're reaching towards the window. So I've got to get them into the sun, but really big. They were planted straight into the soil. These two over here were germinated in, or these three were germinated in the paper towel. And these are very uninspiring, much further behind.
15 days after these were planted straight into the soil, they are getting pretty leggy, so I'm going to put them outside. And they are by far my strongest zucchini seedlings.
So with our seed pods, this is 16 days after they were germinated. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 pods here, and only 1, 2, 3, 4 have successfully germinated. I suspect a key reason is the seeds that went in didn't fully get covered. There's a hole in here. And I could have added soil on top, but I wanted to test how they worked just as they were naturally. They also dried out really quickly, so I kept watering these at least once a day. I would usually spray them twice a day, and that wasn't enough because they dry out. So personally, I'm not a fan, but that's pretty convenient now, and that can be planted straight into the soil. But those roots aren't going to last in there for very long before they get squashed and run out of room.
So there you have it. The seed raising pods, they do work, but they do not work particularly well compared to other traditional methods. I've got lots of more videos like this coming up in the making and also on my channel already. They take a lot of time to put together because I record everything that happens along the way, but there's some really exciting and interesting things in the mix. So subscribe if you want to see more of it, and you'll get a little notification when the next one pops up. If there's a question I need answering, I will do a bit of research, but more often than not, I will do an experiment. So if you're into experiments, you want to see the best way of gardening without having to go through the weeks and months of doing the experiments yourself, subscribe. And even more importantly, like this video and leave a comment telling me what you want to see in the future, and I'll get right to it. Cheers. Happy gardening.